Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zollo Tech, and today Apple re-released iOS 15 Beta 2 to developers. Now they released this with a new build number because they released iOS 15 Public Beta 2. Apple had said this would be coming out in July, we're a day early, and so they released it now. And you can see it says Public Beta 2, which matches Beta 2 of the developer beta. This is because when Beta 3 comes out, they don't have to have Beta 2 for the public beta and Beta 3 for the developer beta. So we'll just have Beta 3, then Beta 4, and so on. So that makes a lot of sense. And as you can probably already see, it's a huge install. So on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, even though I was already on Beta 2, the re-release was 5.3 gigabytes on my 12 Pro Max. It was 1.5 gigabytes on the iPhone 6S Plus. So something changed in the background that's pretty major, or maybe there was just a bunch of fixes that they implemented at the same time, even though it's the same sort of update. Now, along with this, they also re-released iPadOS 15 Beta 2, and then they also have public betas available for not only iOS, but iPadOS, watchOS 8, tvOS, and soon macOS Monterey. And so we'll have those very soon. And if you want to try out the beta, you can go to beta.apple.com. And I'll have a separate video on how to install this and what you should know if you do install this, and sort of to give you a walkthrough on how to do that. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to settings, then we'll go to general, then about. And if you tap on the software version where it says 15.0, you can see the build number, and it's 19A5281J. And this particular build is a J where the prior one was H. And in this build, there isn't a new modem update. So there's no new modem update, at least on my 12 Pro Max, coming from beta 2 to the beta 2 re-release. And as far as new changes, there isn't really anything new that I'm finding that's different from the developer beta 2 that was out a little while ago. So it looks like it's a re-release to bring us up to speed with the public beta so that we have matching build numbers and similar changes. Now there is a feature I left out of the beta 2 video, and that's if we go into a website, tap on the three dots, then go down to print, there's some new options there. So you'll see we not only have the new print screen I've talked about before, where you can save this as a PDF. If you don't have a printer selected, just tap print and you can save it as a PDF. And then we have orientation at the bottom where we can just change this around. So there's some new options there as well. And that's what's new that I haven't mentioned before. So there's not a whole lot of changes. If you've seen my beta 1 and beta 2 videos, everything's basically the same. So you're going to have all the updated features, such as the new weather app, for example, with all of the different things like the map and UV index and all of those things just combined in, as well as the ability to have focus modes, which I really like. So you have the different focus modes for whatever you set up, whether that be gaming or at home. These are things I use all the time, where you can rearrange your home screen based on the focus you want. So I have home screens for the evening where it disables certain things. So if I go into settings, for example, I can disable different things, change my home screens around, see my pages, and these are the pages I want when I'm on my home screen. I've shown all of this in the previous beta, but I just wanted to let you know that this one was out. Now, so far, this seems to be mostly a stability and bug fix update. They haven't said anything specifically other than what was there with the previous beta 2 release. And if you're ever wondering about where you can see everything that's a known issue or what they've actually fixed, you can go over to the feedback app, and in feedback, go to the inbox. In the inbox, find the relevant version. So you can see iOS and iPadOS 14.7, Big Sur. And then we want to go down to iPad or iOS and iPadOS 15 Beta 2 release notes. And you'll see it was updated on the 24th. They haven't updated it today, meaning there's nothing new other than what they've mentioned before. But you can see all the known issues in here. So there's known issues and they're alphabetical. From the App Store, for example, again, known issues, resolved. And then you have known issues with Authenticator, all sorts of things. If you scroll down through, you'll see files and Find My, fonts, focus, foundation. A lot of different things are mentioned here. And as betas go on, they update this regularly and tell you what's been fixed. Now, if you're having an issue that's specific to, say, Find My, make sure it's not in the notes already, that they're not aware that it's a known issue. So if you go to Find My, you'll see that there's two known issues. If it's a known issue, then they're already working on it. If not, make sure you report that feedback. But this specific update seems to be mostly a bug fix and to bring us up to the build number that's the same as the public beta. So nothing new as far as that goes. that they've actually told us anyway. Now, that doesn't mean they haven't fixed anything, as performance seems to be very, very good on this device. But first, let's take a look at battery life. So if we go to settings, we'll go down to battery. My battery health on this phone is at 98%. That's pretty good since I've used it every single day since it was released and charged it every single night. So that's not bad at all. And then if we go back, we'll look at the last 10 days. And on beta 2, it's okay. It doesn't have amazing battery life. I'm getting about maybe 6 hours of screen on time total if I was to use the battery all the way. But you can see yesterday I had 1 hour and 37 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 3 minutes of screen off time, and used about 30% of the battery. That's not that great, but it is an early beta. Hopefully this beta fixes some of the issues that maybe were draining that. Maybe that's one of the bigger updates they've included. So I would expect some changes with that, and we'll see what it's like over the next few days. But if your battery is going down very quickly, I would give it a day or two for everything to stabilize after installing such a huge update. Now, as far as performance overall, it definitely feels fast compared to the previous version. Right after rebooting, even on older devices such as the iPhone 6S, it seems like it's much better than it was on the prior beta. So this was on beta 2, now it's on the beta 2 re-release, and it seems much, much better. There's almost no stutter now. It seems to be performing much better like you would expect. So again, if I go into music, we'll wait for it to load. Gives it just a moment here. And there we go. So even though it just loaded, it seems nice and fast. This is pretty impressive as far as the speed overall. So I'm pretty impressed in general with the performance. On the iPad, there's not anything particularly different other than what I've mentioned in previous videos, but there's a lot of features where you can move the widgets around. So if you're trying out the public beta, you can try it out on your iPad all the way back from the iPad Air 2 all the way to this newer M1 iPad Pro from 2021. So it's really nice to use. I've been using it on the iPad almost without any bugs. It's pretty impressive. Now, as far as the overall Geekbench scores, I did run those just to share those with you. Let's go ahead and take a look. And if we go into Geekbench, you'll see that I ran this 2 times because the first score was kind of low. It was doing things in the background, but I scored 1,603 for single core, 4,108 for multi-core. If we go into the history, we'll go to CPU. And let's scroll down to today. Now you can see that it's a little bit higher for single core and multi-core than the previous beta 2. So it has gone up a little bit. So 1603 versus 1589 and 4108 versus 4058. So that's pretty good considering I just installed it. Now let's take a look at these other devices along with it. Now from left to right, I have the iPad Pro 12.9 from 2021, followed by the iPhone 6S Plus, then the iPhone 11, which is actually on the previous beta 2, since I was trying to find differences between the different betas, and then also the iPhone 12 Pro Max on the far right. So far, I'm pretty impressed with the scores just after installing an update. Usually they're a little bit less, but they're quite good right away. So that's a good sign. And that leads me to, should you install iOS 15 public beta 2? If you've been waiting to try iOS 15, I would say this is generally a sign that it's stable enough that you can actually try it. Now, there are a couple warnings or risks involved. If you do this, make sure that you have a backup, and also be aware that you could have bugs, poor battery life in different apps not working or crashing. Some banking apps, for example, weren't working in beta 2 for some people. So if there's critical things that you're needing to use, I would recommend against updating to this until it's released to the public later in the year, usually in late September. However, if you're aware of maybe apps not working and that's not a problem for you, or maybe you have a secondary phone, then absolutely. Also, keep in mind that you cannot go back to iOS 14 without using a computer. So as long as you have access to that and you have your phone backed up, you should be good to go. And so far, beta 2 has been pretty stable. So at this point, you can definitely try it out if you were waiting to try it out, but there still will be bugs, and you should report those in feedback if you're having problems with those. Now, as far as iOS 15 beta 3, well, based on what they've been releasing lately, maybe we'll see it next week, late next week, if they're releasing them later, or it could be the following week, early in the week. Generally, it's in a 2 week cycle or so. The first beta was about 17 days out, so we could see that maybe another 17 days total, or maybe they'll do it every 2 weeks. Based on what they've done in the past, now that the second beta is out or the second re-release, I would expect maybe late next week or the following week. But we just don't know. Apple's really been random about this. Also, if you were wondering about iOS 14.7, I would expect a beta this coming week, early in the week, and maybe a final release the week after that. However, they haven't said any of this publicly, so we don't know exactly when it's going to release. But that's it for iOS 15 Beta 2, and I'm hoping for a Beta 3 very soon, maybe in a week or two, like I said. And if I find any other features, I'll be sure to let you know in a different video. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.